Blackstone Publishing presents Benjamin Franklin by Kathleen Krull. This book is read by Tavia Gilbert. To Susan Cohen and Brianne Johnson, KK. Introduction. If I have seen further than other people, it is by standing upon the shoulders of giants. Isaac Newton, 1675. Every kid in school knows Benjamin Franklin as one of America's most important founding fathers. The fun one, buff and muscular in his youth, chubby and balding as he aged. He wrote essays about farting, prided himself on his flirting skills with women, had a quip for any situation, and almost always kept his cool. But not everyone knows that Ben Franklin is considered America's first scientist. For his discoveries and theories about electricity, he looms large in the history of physics. It was science, and his passion for it, that kept him alive and active until age 84 and made him sorry to leave this earth. He understood that life-changing discoveries would be made that he unfortunately wouldn't be around to see. The rapid progress true science now makes occasions my regretting sometimes I was born so soon, he said. Scientist wasn't even a word in the early 1700s when Franklin was born. A person pursuing questions about the physical world was called a philosopher of nature, or natural philosopher. And there was almost no way to be one full-time. A person needed a day job, which, for Franklin, was printer and publisher, or to be independently wealthy, which he eventually became. When Ben was born in 1709, there was no United States. The 13 colonies in America belonged to England. Ben was one of the first to suggest they unite and separate from the British king. There were no public libraries, medical schools, or hospitals. Even indoor plumbing was rare. The state of medical care was appalling. Anyone could set himself up as a doctor. During Franklin's teens, only one of the 10 doctors in Boston had any university training. Childbirth was so perilous that women risked their lives every time they went into labor. What with diseases like the much-dreaded smallpox, known as the speckled monster for the ugly sores it inflicted, the specter of starvation and harsh winters, most people did not live past 40. Deadly fires, often sparked by mysterious lightning or open fireplaces, could burn up whole villages. Natural disasters were viewed as punishment from God. Misfortune might be blamed on witches doing the devil's work. In Salem, Massachusetts, only 14 years before Franklin was born, scores of people, most of them women, were accused of witchcraft. 20 were executed. However, scientific thought was coming to a crossroads. It would veer away from superstition and toward logical theories that could be tested and proven. In Europe, the scientific revolution was underway, the work of Isaac Newton its cornerstone. Newton was the one to show how our universe functions by the laws of mathematics. The period that started around 1650 was known as the Age of Enlightenment, with intellectuals using reason to advance knowledge of our world. But in the new world, science lagged behind. What passed for a science lecture in the colonies might flit between topics like Newton's theory of light, eye diseases, Dr. William Harvey's theory of blood circulation, health tips, and cute performance pieces with sparks from static electricity. Franklin was a rational thinker. He was also a man with a very practical mind. Yes, theoretical questions fascinated him, but he always sought the useful benefits of science, how life could be made more comfortable, enjoyable, and safe. Plus, for Ben, all scientific endeavor was pure joy. His face always wore its happiest expression when he was discussing questions about the natural world. At 42, when he could afford to retire, he proudly announced that he would like to give himself leisure to read, study, make experiments. Electricity, health.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.